Hello guys, and welcome to my first official Icelandic vlog, hence these Icelandic flags. Did you know I'm in Iceland? But boy, guys, do I have a story for you today. That's all I have to say. Basically, last weekend, me and four other friends that I met, because they're all au pairs as well, decided to do a little weekend trip to the Westman Islands, or I'll put the Icelandic name here because, you know, I can't pronounce that. But yeah, we decided just to go on Saturday and come back Sunday and spend one night. So Saturday morning, I drove and picked everyone up, and we had the most gorgeous drive ever the whole time. Beautiful sunrise, beautiful snow. It was magical.
Westman Islands.
How do you feel?
I'm dying. Literally in frozen. Almost. Only if we were in Norway. Only if we were in
Norway. Norway.
In Madland, I've seen snow before, guys.
This is such a good progression.
In due time. Who's ready to be in the video?
There you go.
How'd you do it?
Listen.
Don't show me texting and driving. No cameras, please. No cameras. Get this apple playing in the background, honestly. Like, this is me. Yeah. This is me on a road.
Then once we arrived at our port, we just took a 30-minute ferry to the island. First, when we got to the island, we decided to hike up a volcano because the island is like really famous because the volcano erupted a while ago and like destroyed a whole bunch of houses and also created a lot of new earth. I think that the island is called like the Pompeii of the North, if that gives you any indication of what it's like. So we decided to hike up this volcano.
We're hiking to a volcano, and this is a house. Oh. Nelly is our history. What is it?
This history.
How long is it?
It happened in 1960.
Ish.
There were houses, and now? Not anymore.
The end result of that looks so beautiful, but I don't know if you can tell. Actually, I'll put in a clip here that is without the music over it. Insanely windy, like literally we were debating multiple times, even going up, and it started raining. Yeah, so luckily Nelly pushed us and we made it to the top and we got a good photo, but we literally had to go back down hand in hand, one at a time, and it was that windy and crazy. Again, should have been a sign of things to come. And when we got back down, we went back to our Airbnb to try to, well, one, to eat lunch, but then also to try to dry off. Fast forward a couple hours later and we were not any more dry, like nothing dried. So we put on our wet clothes and decided to go back out and see what else the island had to offer.
Venturing back off now. We're slightly warm, but still very, very wet.
The restaurant next to
goodbye. The facing the cold again. Oh, we journey out. I feel like I should make like a documentary here. Like, it's so cold. Oh, it's so cold and rainy. Guys.
What did I change my pants?
Go, guys, go, go, go.
Like we did something, guys.
Look like you're exploring.
Again, it was so rainy, so windy, so cold. We went to an aquarium because the island is like famous for puffins, but they're not there like in nature during the winter. So we thought we'd just try to see one at the aquarium. But turns out that the puffin that it was the aquarium that you take pictures with died. So yeah, not very good luck. Then we went by this concert hall and they were advertising that there was this really big popular band coming. And some guy approached us about going to that, but then he told us it was sold out. So I'm like, what? So yeah, we basically just wandered around the island for like half an hour more until we were so cold, we just decided to retreat back to our room and watch Netflix. Then in the evening, we went out to get food, but just at a restaurant right next to our place, because again, cold, windy, rainy. For the rest of the evening, we just stayed at our place and actually had a really good time just chatting and playing games and drinking wine.
This is our evening setup.
Oh, you're gonna make me do this again.
So could you just, I'm gonna put a whole bunch of pictures that we just took in this video. This is what it's like when it's freezing cold outside and you're poor. You bring your own wine and drink it out of frozen cups. And we're gonna play a meme game. Honestly, my ideal evening.
Then the next morning we had to be up bright and early because the original route we were gonna take to get back to the original port was too dangerous. So we had to take a different route and we had to leave earlier. Again, we thought nothing of. We were like, cool, great. And the beginning was just very beautiful. However, things quickly took a turn because we realized that the boat ride was 3 hours. It was also going to drop us an hour and a half away from our original port, which is where the car is. And yeah, then it was really, really, really rough. Got to the point where you couldn't even really walk around the ship because you were just holding on to stuff. Like you couldn't, like literally it was just like boom, boom, boom. And I've never gotten seasickness, nor had any of the other girls, except for Madeline. So she knew what she was doing. She got on that boat and the girl hunkered down and she just like slept the whole time. The rest of us just frolicking around, thinking we're having such a good time until the seasickness hit. Millie went down first and I got a message saying, Millie's throwing up, come help. And then I was like, great, I'll go help. And I started throwing up. Then basically everyone threw up. It's literally like every woman for themselves. Like we all just got like dispersed in different parts of the ferry. We were all just on our own. I was sitting in the movie room and it was right by the bathroom and you could literally just hear everybody throwing up in the bathroom. And it wasn't just us like tourists that were throwing up, like Icelandic people were throwing up. The men, the women, the children, everybody. They had puke buckets out. It was literally insane. And for 3 hours, I just sat there and tried to sleep and tried to focus on breathing and not throwing up. And again, like we were all separated. We couldn't even message each other because if I looked at my phone, you know I was gonna throw up again. So it was just 3 hours of hecticness. We somehow all survived and we made it to land and then we got on the bus and luckily Millie had the energy to vlog because the rest of us were all still just trying to recover from the traumatic event.
So we are now going to harbor. We are going to
be survived.
I'm not gonna take the ferry again. And we are going to pick our car.
So close yet so far away.
Yeah. Yeah. 1 hour, 10 minutes take 10 years for me. Bye bye. How do you feel?
I feel that I have survived a lot this weekend. I have overcome a lot. And we are all bonded now for life by our puking on the ferry. Do you agree?
Yes. Okay. See you later.
So finally, an hour and a half later, we made it back to our car. We decided not to give up and to stop at a few other places along the way home.
Guess tell the people where we are now, Millie.
We are going to a waterfall and I don't know.
This is the waterfall.
I don't know how to do the pronunciation.
I can't pronounce it either, but we've been through a lot today and we're still carrying on, guys. We're getting the Viking spirit now, you know, not giving up.
Yeah guys, after that we basically just finished driving home. The drive home again was so beautiful, snowy, and then we saw a triple rainbow. What? But we still, you know, we're all trying to recover from that boat. Again, I've never gotten seasickness. Basically none of us had, so the fact that we all threw up was crazy. I guess it seems like it could have been a terrible trip, but or like a fail, but honestly, like since we were all together, we were just laughing through the whole thing. So it was a really great trip. Honestly, tell me guys if you've ever had seasickness or if you've ever experienced something like this, because it's good to know that I'm not alone. Alright guys, I'm gonna try to block that out of my memory now. Not the trip, just the seasickness. And I'll see you soon.